This is Plus TV Africa, where big stories live. Welcome to Tea Time, where we'll bring you the biggest entertainment stories. My name is Elsie Godwin, and I've got my co-anchors with me, Ewa Oluwa Ritu and Ife Oluwa Oshunke.
Hi, guys.
How are you doing?
Amazing.
I'm bad.
Ife, how
are
you doing?
I'm good. I haven't just gotten enough sleep.
What did you do last night?
Depression.
Depression? Okay.
Yeah.
Have you seen a doctor or have you tried to see a psychologist?
I'll be seeing. I have a doctor's appointment later today. So, yeah. So, I haven't been able to sleep. I've been suffering from insomnia. So, I'm just saying.
Is it insomnia or depression?
Yeah, because I'm depressed. So, I haven't been able to sleep for a while.
So, how did you know you're depressed? Just feel depressed?
No, I don't feel depressed.
You've
I know when I'm
depressed. You've been diagnosed as a depressed patient.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Okay, moving on to more serious stories. Big Brother Naija 2019 housemate Gideoni Ekpata has been appointed as special assistant to Cross River State Governor Ben Ayade on garment factory and branding. A statement released by the Cross River State Governor's media aide Christian Ethan notes that the appointment is with immediate effect.
Okay, so congratulations to Gideoni. I'm happy for him. And then I was wondering, garment making and branding. But then I think there's a big garment making factory in Cross River that they are trying to, you know, maybe bring back to life or work on it so it will be bigger or better.
So maybe advice on that also.
And I say,
it's just interesting. I find it very interesting. But yeah, congratulations
River,
to him.
One of the most what's it called now? Indigenous people when it comes to their outfits, you understand? So when it comes to garments making, but my question is Gideoni a fashion designer? What does he really know about garment factory and branding? Do you understand? If we're talking about the people of, what's the name of this guy from Ghana that was on Big Brother as well, Big Brother Africa, that was a fashion designer, and then he got an appointment, I would say that, okay, probably that's the reason why they chose him. But Gideoni, what does he really know about garments, factories, and production? So,
well, I mean, we can't answer that because maybe we don't know that part of him. Maybe he was able to prove himself worthy of that position to the governor. So we really can't answer that here because we don't know what exactly they are looking for in that particular for that particular position. And maybe he has it.
Well, this just brings me to the conclusion that I think I need to start going on more often. Because I think I need this special advisor on the media and all of that with my government.
They find you worthy, yeah.
Yeah, they find me. Don't you think I'm worthy?
Of which part?
Eh?
Which part?
Entertainment and lifestyle.
Special advisor.
Yeah, do you understand?
And I mean, I think only if the people appointed will, you know, do their job and then will feel the impact and the difference. I think Governor Ayade is trying to bring in young people on board and... Let's see
but
how this turns out.
Just special assistants, so even if they tell, they don't have so much role.
But I mean, they are there to at least advise. They are there. I mean, this thing is like stage by stage. Let's at least applaud somebody that is making an attempt.
No, I applaud the attempt. Yeah. My confusion from the beginning is the garments factory. Like, I don't understand that. And maybe if he's
they have the garments,
they have it. Is it Gideoni that's supposed to advise you on running that? What Ife says is, as far as I'm concerned, is valid because I don't know his background on that. And I think people we put into power owes us that explanation
exactly.
Let us know this and this is the reason. Even if you're not just giving us a name, oh, this person has been appointed as this, that person, why is this person appointed? Even if not why, what is the person's profile and biography? So once you read it, your own brain will tell you, oh, this is why this person is good for this role. Not just handing out appointments because you think, okay, I don't know what the reason is. But
for me, I just feel that if maybe he has been able to prove himself worthy,
I get proving to the governor, but the people they are governing also needs to know what exactly is going on before. I mean, when we talked about, to be frankly, on this table, I don't think anybody contested the fact that Ubi should be a good hand when it comes to tourism and entertainment and all that. So nobody argued that. But for this one, it's just a simple case of why putting out a statement, give us a press release that includes his bio and profile in it. So people understand what you're doing. So it's not a case of, oh, we are just giving out appointments to whoever is popular or in the government's coffers as our friends, you know.
I get what you're saying, but maybe because they don't do it that way before. That's why, I mean, most of the time when they appoint these people, they don't give out their information or whatever it is. So maybe that's
this is they need to start because so, one of the things
you can just call, you can call for them to start. So
I even need to call for them to do, because if you understand communication and your role, then it is what you're supposed to do.
Especially
in a media
when it comes
age,
to
not
politics,
even right now.
And when you are being in charge of a lot of the population's lives, because if you're talking about the population of the people from Cross River, then you need to give them a valid reason why this person is fit for the job. Because if I wasn't fit for this job, if you were not fit for this job, if you were not fit for this job, we wouldn't be on this table. It's like bringing a fashion designer now to come and say, okay, come and be a presenter. You may be good at your job, but what's your background? Do you understand? So you need to actually let us know that, okay, what background do these people have for them to get these positions? Are we just doing, oh, favoritism? I know you, you know me, so I can give you a political appointment, which is a problem we're facing in this country in the first place, because we put square pegs in a circle, in a round Oh, do you understand? Because if you're not fit for the job, why are you being appointed in the first place? Do you understand? So that bothers me, and that just makes me feel like, okay, politics is about who you know, the people you roll with, and that's how you get appointments. And I don't think that's the way it is, because if that's the way it is, you will not be able to serve me.
That's the way it is, but that's not how it's supposed to be.
Yeah, so if that's the way it is, then you can't serve everybody in their capacity, in that capacity. And I have a problem with that. So I think Gadoni should release a press statement, like Kelsey said, and say, oh, I used to be involved in fashion designing, I created this garment.
Or whatever it is that made
qualify for
anyway,
the
let's just move on to the next story. Never be ashamed of your scars. They will turn you into a star. This is coming from Nollywood actress and businesswoman Mercy Ayigbe. She's looking back and sharing some lessons. In an inspirational message she shared on Instagram, along with the photo from her domestic violence saga, she said, and I quote, "I want to reach out to someone out there. You think your life has been decimated by scars. You find it hard to forgive yourself and others that have been part of the mess in your life. I have good news for you. Your mess will soon become a message. Your errors are gradually turning you into a hero. Your trials will soon become triumph. Your adversity is turning to your advancement. Your frustration will soon become your fuel, and your scars will one day turn you into a star." So basically, she was just using her post to encourage people, to let them know that whatever they're going through now is not the end of life. There's always a better part of it. So,
well, something I got from all of this is that victims of domestic violence should really speak up. Do you understand? There was this, I'm sorry, I'm dragging Teddy and Bam Bam into this all over again. When Teddy was accused of beating up Bam Bam and all of that, we also agreed on this table that we just hope a few years down the line you will not come to retract your statement to say that no, he has never done that. Because if a man keeps hating on a woman, then you need to speak up. Because at the end of the day, we've seen cases of women who've lost their life to domestic violence and all of that. So one particular thing I took away from our message is that, look, if you're suffering any form of violence, domestic violence from a man, kindly speak up. I'm sure she stayed in it for a while, thinking that, okay, it will get better and all of that. And it led to bruises all over her face. And I think any man who would do that to a woman is a beast.
Honestly, I think it's easy to advise people to, you know, leave the marriage, but when they are in that position, I feel like it's not. If it was easy, a lot of people would not really want to stay there. And
I think it's naive women.
We can only just keep, you know, talking to them or advising them or speaking up that, you know, if you're going through this, just speak up. But like, you can't put so much pressure on them at that point to, you know, leave their marriage.
No, I didn't say leave. I said speak up.
Well, from speak what up. Her message, what I picked from it is, now, I think she's speaking, I don't know what her aim is in this message, but for me, it reflects more on those that have found the courage to speak and are out, and sometimes, or even when they are trying to come out, they feel like it's the end of the road. If I leave, what's going to happen to me, and how is it? And she's basically saying, regardless of what it has been, you have to forgive yourself for the choices you have made, because sometimes you don't even blame the person abusing you. You blame yourself for choosing this person. You start asking yourself, didn't I see this sign? Why did I end up? What have I done? What kind of sin have I committed for God to send this kind of, you know? So you question yourself over and over again, and you don't forgive yourself. So I think she's just advising people to really forgive themselves.
I like the message.
And be able to move on from the hurt, because yes, you've been hurt, yes, you've gone through the pain, but you have to be able to pick yourself up back, because if you don't pick yourself, nobody's going to do it for you. She also said something that's your own choice. Being able to pick is not being abused might be inevitable, but being able to move on from that pain is not inevitable. It is your own choice. So if you decide to stay in it and not look for opportunities for yourself and come out of it and forgive yourself, then you'll be there. Nobody can help you out of it if you're not ready to help yourself. For me, that's what I picked.
I like the message. I'm coming from somebody that is a victim myself.
Yeah.
So people will understand. People that are in that position will understand, and they'll be able to relate better. So I think more women that have been able to, you know, get themselves out of this need to start speaking up to encourage other women that are in their shoes to, you know, get out of it. So.
Okay.
And I think there should be a maximum prison sentence for men who lay their hands on women. Do you understand? Like, they should be serving, like, 50 years in jail. No, for real. Because we keep referring, before the old feminist thing, we keep referring to women as the weaker vessel, as the ones we need to protect. So if those women are looking up to you for them to be protected, for them to be loved, for them to be cared for, and then you think the way to pay them back is by beating, no matter what a woman does, you need to still show her love, because it's not easy being a woman to even start with. Now, this
okay, so the thing is, men that eat women, yeah, they are cowards in the first place. So I think one of the problems is the fact that woman is not looking up to them for a lot of things.
And I think the society, where the problem starts, and so upbringing also comes into play. So this is going out to all the young parents and aspiring parents as well. What you show your kids at the things that they would actually display when they also get married. So try to be a good father. Try not to lay your hands on their mother before this golden.
Right. If we start going into reasons or causes of domestic violence, it's actually a complicated one, but all I know is that it cannot be tolerated. And if you are in an abusive relationship, please, finding your way out of it is very important, except you want to be dead in it. Let's go on a quick break, but when we come back, we definitely have more to discuss. Welcome to Tea Time on Plus TV Africa, where we bring you the biggest entertainment stories and, of course, analyze them for you.
You can have both parents and still end up as a useless child. I see them every day.
Most times, I worry more about where I'm coming from and where I am now. Wow. And that determines my next step.
Why are you sounding like Alibaba right now?
Plus TV Africa, we're feeling good. No time to dull, everybody feeling all right.
And people are still buying. Sometimes I look myself minimal IO.
Apala music is for mature minded people. I got DM sometimes from Malawi, like, woo!
Sleeping early.
Sleeping early.
If they cheat on you and you are crying in 2020, oh, Lokpolo, oh, they're any bias so thorough. If your boyfriend should cheat on you, he won't go and be back by one or cheating. One cheater plus one cheater make what? Wale? Make two cheetah. Two over four is equals to what? Two, I get four. You go, you will cheat. You will not only cheat with somebody like him. Yes! Yaoda! On top of love, you will be suffering on top of love. I love my boyfriend. Whereas, boyfriend is spending lots of million on another girl outside.
Okay. Over to you too.
Why?
No, just...
You're starting.
Okay, I mean, I agree with her and I've posted it already. Like, it could be joke, it could be all jokes, but the fact that I don't agree for anyone to cheat, but because there's already this mindset that cheating is for men, so when a lady does it, it's like, no, everybody wants to eat her raw. But once it's a guy, let it be. So what is good for the, how do they speak the English?
What is good for the girls is good for the gander.
So if you do not want to be responsible as a man to understand that you are in a committed relationship and not cheat, if you feel like you can do it and it's okay because you are wired like that, you think we don't see six pack and five men and we are wired and feel like, oh God, this is so good, we want this. We also have that feeling, but we control it because we understand that.
But you know women cheat for the men.
Let's not even go there, please.
I don't know, but I'm talking about what Ten is talking about.
Right,
so if you find yourself in that situation,
let me tell you a song that would just debunk whatever you're saying. Yeah. They say two wrongs don't make a right.
That's what has kept us.
No, for me, honestly, I don't agree with it. I think that if your partner is cheating on you, male or female, if you're not comfortable with it, it's that you walk away. That's, I mean, it's just really somehow if you're cheating back. And how is that even going to help you?
Anything.
I mean, your relationship would not progress. Is it that you're breaking it or you're talking it out? I mean, we've had a situation that people have had like a cheating partner, and after sometimes they talked about it and it was over. I mean, it just gets really crazy. Like Fair rightly said, two wrongs don't make it right. So if your partner is cheating and then you don't feel comfortable with it and you try talking to them and they can't stop, I think you should just move on. Maybe you don't deserve that person.
Can I personalize this question to you? So if your man cheats on you, are you going to sleep with his friend, his father, his brother?
Maybe not his friend.
That was not what was said in this video.
No, that's what she said in the freestyle.
That's the freestyle. We're talking about the video.
No, I know, but it's all encompassing the whole thing.
I don't think Elsie is talking
focusing on this video. I don't have a business with the father and the son. Nah, that's not my business.
That's not my business. Mm-hmm.
But I'm just saying, even if... nobody, like, you don't have to cheat back. Don't let somebody change you from who you are or make you an evil person or the
but
bad
that's
person.
That's the content of the freestyle.
So,
if we play the video and we are focusing on this video, the freestyle is actually really vulgar and it's not something we can start talking about on TV.
We can't play. But she's saying that, look, if your man should cheat on you.
Is that what you heard from this video?
Not this video. Oh, I'm talking about everything now. When you do the whole research and you want to put the whole thing she said before this particular video, she did a freestyle video where she was advising women that, look, if your man should cheat on you, sleep with your father, sleep with your brother, their best friends, and all of that.
It felt like you rightly said she was advising. So if you have sense, ask yourself the question, even if you want to cheat, should you cheat with his father and his brother? So that's not even... something that should be debated.
True that.
Anyway, at least I know cheating is wrong. It shouldn't be done at all, but... complicated case calls for complicated measures.
Okay.
Anyway, I think this is where we wrap up this episode of Tea Time. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel at Plus TV Africa to catch up on this conversation, or visit our YouTube channel again at Plus TV Africa to just watch. You can also watch Tea Time on Auto TV and in London on Ben Television. My thank you as always go to my co-anchors, Ife Oluwatch, okay, and Ewa Oluwaritu, and the entire production team. My name is Elsie Godwin saying thank you for watching and see you later. Yeah.